Good morning.
Good morning.
Today is the fourth Sunday in Advent.
We're gathered today to hear and share praises to God, who comes to us.
Indeed, God comes to us in our lives.
Through his messengers, we hear him. They comfort us and show us the glory of the living God.
We light this fourth candle.
To remember the witness of the heavenly host, which lifted its praise to God at the birth of Christ.
Lord, fill every heart with praise for Jesus Christ. Let us sing, O come Emmanuel, on your insert. We won't tell on you.
Oh, I'm sure someone will.
Yes. I'm just new here, been here a couple of weeks, but I'm a 57-year member of Masons, and I'm just glad to be here.
Good.
But we want everybody to be happy to be here, so you can smile. You are allowed to do that.
Well, we have one we don't want to forget, and it's in our choir, and she's in our prayers. It's been the last 3 weeks now. She's been going through quite an ordeal, and she needs all of us to take her in our thoughts and our considerations and ask the good Lord to touch her and get her back in. This is her seat right here, Father, so she is missed. June Crawford.
Okay.
And all those dear people that were in the pathway, those terrible.
Oh, yeah. Yes. The folks down south in the path of that tornado, the devastation. So, yes, yes. Not only those people, but the people who are going down there to lend a hand and paying out of their own pockets to do so. So, well, let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you for this opportunity to gather together in this chapel and worship you. And the prayers today that are spoken and unspoken, we know that you will address. And in our hearts we have other prayers that only you know. So today we ask that you reach out and touch everyone with your grace. And Lord, as we all pray together the way you have taught us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into temptations,
but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Amen.
Special music now is to Go Tell It on the Mountain. Father, Prince of Peace, and of increase of his government and peace there will be no end. Upon the throne of David, and over his kingdom to establish it and to uphold it with justice and righteousness from this time forth and evermore. Amen. Our New Testament reading, of course, comes from Luke. If you watch Charlie Brown this week, you've heard it. Well, you know, Charlie Brown's nice, he's cute, and it does say a good message. That's back when you could do this on television and not catch a whole lot of flack about it. But, as we are inundated since Halloween with Christmas, with sales and things like that. I mean, as soon as you walk in the store the day Halloween is over, maybe even before, There are the Christmas ornaments, there are the gift sales, buy your new mattress, whatever it is. So we commercially have lost touch with what this was all about. And this from Luke is exactly what it is all about. And in those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all of the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment. When Quirinius was governor of Syria, and all went to be enrolled, each to his own city. And Joseph, who went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of the lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered. And she gave birth to her first son. And she wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in that region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid. For behold, I bring to you good news of great joy, which come to all people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you, that you will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was an angel, with the angel, a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God of the highest, and on earth peace among all men with whom he is pleased." The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
All right, so let's think about this just for a minute. We can get past the sale of used cars and, you know, that kind of thing. You got to kind of take into consideration the time frame that we're talking about. Now, cities back then, believe it or not, were a little more modern than what we give it credit for. They actually had brick and stone and things like that. They weren't all adobe, you know, thatch huts or things like that. But Bethlehem was busy. It was a good-sized town. And the noise and the bustle of the city had begun early that morning. As the morning rose at the dawn, the people were already out on the streets. Vendors were parking themselves on the corners of almost every traveled street. All the country routes. And the store owners were unlocking the doors of their shops. Children were awakened to dogs barking and donkeys pulling carts. And the owner of the inn had gotten up earlier than usual. After all, the inn was full. All of the beds were taken. Every available mat and blanket had been put to use. And soon the customers would be up and around, and there would be work to do. People needed fed, needed water. So can you imagine the conversation of that innkeeper and his family at the breakfast table? Did anyone mention the arrival of the young couple the night before? Did anyone check on them? Did anyone notice that the girl on the donkey was pregnant? Yeah, probably not. There was really nothing special about it. They were just one of several families that were turned away during the night. And besides, who has the time to worry about them? Caesar Augustus had done the economy of Bethlehem a great favor when he decided to collect taxes and count the census. Travel right now was a booming business. So no, it's doubtful that anyone even noticed. There was too much going on. There was too much to do to notice that the impossible had occurred. God had entered the world as a baby. Yet, had someone happened into the stable on the edge of town that evening, what a sight they may have seen. Now, you got to think about this. The stable stinks, like all stables do. The stable's a barn. And the stench reeks the air, the ground is hard, and straw is scarce. Cobwebs hang from the ceiling, mice scurry across the floor. I'm sure some folks here have been in a barn. I grew up on a farm, I've been in a barn. A lovelier place could not have existed. Now off to one side sits a group of shepherds. They sit silently on the floor, probably just puzzled, maybe in awe, and no doubt amazed. The night watch had exploded into a light from heaven and a symphony of angels. God goes to those who have time to hear it. So on this cloudless night, he went to some simple shepherds. Now, near the young mother sits a weary father. If anyone is dozing, he is. He can't remember the last time he sat down. It's a long walk. And now that Mary and the baby are comfortable, he leans against the wall of the stable and his eyes begin to droop. He's tired. And he still has not figured it all out. The mystery of the entire event confuses him. But right now he doesn't have the energy to argue. And as sleep comes, he remembers the name that the angel Gabriel told him to use. Jesus. Now, Mary's awake. Her head rests on the soft leather of Joseph's saddle. She looks into the face of the baby, her son, her Lord and her Majesty. And at this point in history, the human who best understands who God is a teenage girl in a smelly barn. And she can't take her eyes off of it. So, this is him. He looks nothing like a king. His face is all prunish and red. His cry is healthy and strong, but he's helpless. He is absolutely dependent upon her. Majesty amongst the mundane. Holiness among sheep manure. Divinity on the floor of a stable with a teenage girl and a carpenter. And she touches the face of the infant and she wonders, how long was your journey? This baby had overlooked the entire universe. The rags keeping him warm were robes of eternity. His golden throne room had been abandoned for a sheep pen. And worshiping angels were replaced with shepherds. And meanwhile, the city hums. The merchants are unaware that God has come to the planet. The innkeeper would never believe that he had sent God into the cold. And those who missed His Majesty's arrival that night did not do so because of evil acts or malice. They simply weren't looking. And sometimes I wonder that little has changed in 2,000 years. But one thing is for sure, is that the world would never be the same. Next hymn.
Our closing hymn today will be Let There Be Peace on Earth.
Give them warmth and peace. Amen. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Amen.